I wanted to get your guys' opinion on this, but right now people are just asking the question why. Robinhood, as of right now, when it comes down to ticker symbol AMC and GME, as you can see based off of their tweet, are not allowing traders to execute on their trades when it comes down to buy orders. In light of current market volatility, we are restricting the transactions for certain securities to position closing only, meaning that you can only sell, including AMC and GME, the two most popular ones as of right now. And the part that's the most bothersome about this is that, check this out, AMC dropping aggressively from where it closed at to where it's at as of right now, right? So let's calculate the percentage loss from close to where it's at right now. It has lost 50%. Let's talk about GME. And it's not just these two, right? So all of these stocks are now in the red. GME, BB, AMC, NAKD. From where it closed at yesterday to where we're at right now, it's only down about 14%, right? Not too bad. But it was at overall highs of 500. And with the continuous halt and with Robinhood traders bringing it to our attention that they're no longer allowed to execute these orders. I experienced something very similar where I'm not too sure if it was because of market volatility, but TD Ameritrade wouldn't even allow me to execute on these trades. The part that a lot of people are talking about this right now is especially on Robinhood, the only platform as of right now that's actually restricting so many traders to no longer be able to buy these stocks. I find it very coincidental. You guys let me know down in the comments section. Very coincidental that Robinhood is no longer allowing these companies to be purchased through their trading platform. Robinhood is notorious for having millennial investors, which of course, let's be honest, make up probably a great deal of these Reddit traders. And who is Robinhood partnered with? Citadel. And I looked a little bit more into this, and based off of what I've been able to read, these are just great examples. So it says Citadel's a hedge fund that owns Melvin Capital. That's not in a sense true. Citadel is invested and partnered with Melvin Capital, and they invested billions with Melvin Capital. Melvin Capital is the fund that is being targeted with their short positions. In a sense, Melvin Capital took aggressive short positions on GME, on AMC, and they are being squeezed out of their positions, losing billions. So by Citadel being a partner with Melvin Capital and Melvin Capital losing billions, it means that most likely Citadel is losing billions. And taking that into consideration, with Citadel providing order flows for Robinhood and potentially not agreeing to provide those order flows any longer, it is most likely due to Robinhood's partnership that they are no longer allowing these two stocks to be purchased through their trading platform due to the partnership that they have with Citadel. And there are other trading platforms very similar to Robinhood that are sending out warning messages about the volatility and the increase of risk. I find it so coincidental. Like, I understand, like, the PDT rule, right? It restricts us because, let's be honest, when you're first getting started, especially within the United States, right, it is very overwhelming and you do tend to overtrade. And they position it in a way where now this new restriction that is very coincidental because it happens during a time where Citadel is losing billions potentially by being invested in Melvin Capital because they're being squeezed out, that they choose to no longer provide their order flow for Robinhood, which then Robinhood then goes back to protect themselves and say that we're just not going to no longer allow those two stocks to be purchased within our trading platform. It seems slightly more beneficial for the suits than it does for maybe some new traders that are buying at these higher levels. Let's be honest, I just wish we lived in a world where people were held accountable for their actions. So regardless, if they do lose their butt on their position, they're adults. They opened these accounts, they funded these accounts, and they are the sole people that initiated these trades, and they should be held accountable. I wish we lived in that kind of world, but we don't. And I think that they're being able to mask and cover up this decision of, due to increased volatility, we're no longer going to allow the trading of these two stocks. And it's upsetting because people are now individuals, retail traders, are now losing their portfolios. Let's be honest. Yesterday was probably the peak of a type. In yesterday's video, we talked about, you know, just that today was going to be a critical point. And now every single hype stock, NOK, down 28%. AMC is down 54%. BB is down 40%. And GME is down 24%. They're being destroyed. And it is not that they're being destroyed because us retail traders are no longer trying to trade them, but they're being able to leverage their resources, their trading platforms, to no longer allow people to execute on those trades. I just find it to be a very unfair advantage. I'm all for it. If these stocks crash because the retail people or the people that stand behind it lock in profits, that makes sense. But when we are not giving traders a fair battlefield, it's just pretty bothersome. You guys can let me know in the comment section what you guys think. Are you experiencing these issues? And what are you going to do to no longer put yourself in this position? Robinhood is now restricting this kind of trading. There's so many options out there, right? There's TD Ameritrade, there's Fidelity, there's Webull. I'm gonna put a link down below if you guys wanna download Webull. I believe you guys get a couple free stocks. I get a couple free stocks if you guys want to. You guys don't even have to use my link below if you guys don't want to. You just won't get the free stocks. But there's Interactive Brokers. If you're, you know, outside of the US, you guys have nothing but options. So I wanna remind you that a lot of these trading platforms don't even charge for commissions anymore. It is gonna be a learning curve because you're gonna have to learn how to use that platform. But if you are fed up with Robinhood and its decision to no longer allow this kind of trading because it is in their best interest and not in their users, I just feel like that is not how a business should carry themselves, especially when it's the people that have created Robinhood. It's the millennials, and now the millennials are the ones that are getting the backhand. So I hope that we earned your thumbs up. All the links will be provided for you down below. Just wanted to provide you guys with a quick little update. Don't forget to join our free Facebook group. We have a little bit over 299,000 members, and that is going to be one of the links down in the description if you guys want to stay connected. And of course, it is for free. Like always, let's make sure that we end the year on a green note. Take it easy, team.